Hello, myself, M. S. Basargaon, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now, learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to express Fourier series of even and odd function in the interval minus pi to pi. Now, first of all, here we will see about even and odd functions. First one, even function. A function f of x is said to be even if f of minus x equal to f of x. That is, if you replace x by minus x, again we are getting the same function f of x for all x. Then we can say that the given function is even. Now we'll take some notes. F of x contains only even powers of x and may contain only cos x and sec x. Now secondly, integration from minus a to a f of x dx is equal to twice integration from 0 to a f of x dx when f of x is even. It is a standard theorem of definite integral. Third one, the sum or difference of two even function is even. Fourth one, the product of two even function is even. For example, x square cos x raised to 4 plus cos 2x plus 2. These are the examples of even functions. Now about the odd function. A function f of x is said to be odd if f of minus x equal to minus f of x for all x. Now we will note some points. First one, f of x contains only odd powers of x and may contains only sin x cosec x. Second one, integration from minus a to a f of x dx equal to 0 when f of x is odd. The sum or difference of two odd function is odd function. The product of two odd function is even. The product of an odd function and even function is odd. For example, sin x, x cube. Now pause the video for a while and test whether the following functions are even or odd. I hope you have completed. Now to test even and odd function, here first function is f of x is equal to sin 2x plus x cube. Now in this one, replace x by minus x, that is f of minus x equal to sin of 2 minus x plus minus x raised to 3, which is equal to minus sin 2x minus x cube. Here we can take minus sign common, that is minus sin 2x plus x cube, which is equal to minus f of x. Therefore, f of minus x equal to minus f of x. Therefore, given function is an odd function. Similarly, second, f of x is equal to x raised to 6 plus cos 3x. Now, replacing x by minus x, you get f of minus x equal to minus x raised to 6 plus cos of 3 minus x. That is minus x raised to 6 means x raised to 6. And you know cos of minus theta is cos theta, that is plus cos 3x, which is again given function f of x. Therefore, f of minus x is equal to f of x. Therefore, given function is an even function. Now, Fourier series of even and odd function. Let the Fourier series of the function f of x in the interval minus pi to pi be f of x is equal to a naught plus summation of n equal to 1 to infinity a n cos nx plus b n sin nx. Let us call this as equation number 1, where a naught is equal to 1 by 2 pi integration from minus pi to pi f of x dx. Let us call this as equation number 2, and a n equal to 1 by pi integration from minus pi to pi f of x cos nx dx. Let us call this as equation number 3. And bn equal to 1 by pi integration from minus pi to pi f of x sin nx dx. Let us call this as equation number 4. Now we'll take the case 1. Suppose f of x is an even function in minus pi to pi, then bn will be 0. Since in the integrand in 4, in equation number 4 here, f of x sin nx is odd, is an odd function, then the Fourier series is given by f of x equal to a naught plus summation of n equal to 1 to infinity a n cos nx, where a naught is equal to 1 by 2 pi integration from minus pi to pi f of x dx, which you can write twice, that is 2, 2 will get cancelled, 1 by pi integration from 0 to pi f of x dx, and an is equal to 1 by pi integration from minus pi to pi f of x cos nx dx, which you can write 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi f of x cos nx dx. Now we will consider the case 2. Suppose f of x is an odd function in minus pi to pi, then a naught and a n are 0, because integrand in 3 is an odd function and also a naught is 0 since f of x is odd. Then Fourier series is given by f of x is equal to summation of n equal to 1 to infinity bn sin nx, where bn is equal to 1 by pi integration from minus pi to pi f of x sin nx dx, which we can modify this is equal to 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi f of x sin nx dx. Now we'll see the example. Find the Fourier series of f of x equal to pi square by 12 minus x square by 4 in the interval minus pi to pi, and hence deduce that pi square by 12 is equal to 1 by 1 square minus 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 3 square minus so on. Now here f of x is equal to pi square by 12 minus x square by 4. Now you will test for even and odd function, and for that here we can replace x by minus x, that is f of minus x is equal to pi square by 12 minus, here replacing x by minus x, that is minus x whole square by 4, which is equal to pi square by 12, and minus x whole square is x square, that is minus x square by 4 again, which is f of x. Hence f of minus x is equal to f of x, therefore f of x is equal to pi square by 12 minus x square by 4 is an even function. Hence here the value of bn is 0. Then the Fourier series of even function is given by f of x is equal to a naught plus summation of n equal to 1 to infinity an cos nx, where a naught is equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to pi f of x dx, which is equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to pi, here f of x is pi square by 12 minus x square by 4 dx, which is equal to 1 by pi. Now integrating with respect to x, we get pi square x by 12 minus integration of x square by 4 is x cube by 12 with the limit 0 to pi, which is equal to 1 by pi. Putting the upper limit x equal to pi, that we get pi cube by 12, and for again minus pi cube by 12, and for lower limit putting x equal to 0, both the terms are 0, that is equal to 1 by pi pi cube by 12 minus pi cube by 12, which is equal to 0. Now an is equal to 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi f of x cos nx dx, which is equal to 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi, here f of x is pi square by 12 minus x square by 4 into cos nx dx. Now again here by using generalized rule of integration by part, taking u as a first bracket and v as a cos nx, you can write which is equal to 2 by pi, keeping pi square by 12 minus x square by 4 as it is, and integration of cos nx is sin nx by n, minus the derivative of pi square by 12 minus x square by 4 is, that is 0 minus 2x by 4 into integration of sin nx by n is minus cos nx by n square, plus the derivative of minus 2x by 4 is minus 1 by 2 into bracket integration of minus cos nx by n square is minus sin nx by n cube with the limit 0 to pi. Now put first upper limit, that is we replace x by pi, here we know sin of n pi is 0, therefore the first term will be 0, minus into bracket putting x equal to pi, here we get minus pi by 2, and minus cos of n pi by n square, and minus minus plus, here sin of n pi is 0. Now for lower limit putting x equal to 0, the sin 0 is 0, therefore the first term is 0, and here x is multiplied with cos nx, therefore putting x equal to 0, second term is also 0, and we have again sin 0 is 0, that is for lower limit we get the value 0. Now by simplifying this, which is equal to 2 by pi, that is you get minus into minus into minus, that is minus pi cos of n pi is minus 1 raised to n divided by 2 n square, that is 2, 2 will get cancelled, pi, pi will get cancelled, which is equal to minus of minus 1 raised to n by n square. Hence, f of x is equal to summation of n equal to 1 to infinity. Now we can write this as a minus 1 raised to n plus 1 by n square cos nx. Now here substituting the value of f of x as a pi square by 12 minus x square by 4 and substituting n equal to 1 to infinity, first we will put n equal to 1, that is minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1, that is 2, that is 1 by 1 square cos x. Now putting n equal to 2, we get minus 1 raised to 3 means we get minus 1, and divided by n square means minus 1 by 2 square cos of 2x, and putting n equal to 3 you get minus 1 raised to 4, that is plus 1, plus 1 upon 3 square cos 3x and so on. Let us call this equation number 1. Now putting x equal to 0 in equation number 1, we get the second term will become 0, that is pi square by 12 is equal to, as you know, cos 0 is 1, that is 1 by 1 square. Similarly, cos 0 is 1, that is minus 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 3 square minus so on. References higher in the mathematics by Dr. B.S. Grewal. Thank you.